All right, guys, thanks for getting together. As always, this time of year, we need to start talking about our top 100 list, and I thought the best way to start that off is to talk about some of the very top guys at each position leading up to the draft that's less than 2 months away now. So let's just to start it off, let's start behind the plate with catchers. Who do you guys think are the top catchers that are out there this year?
Well, one guy I've got is a Ole Miss commit from Louisiana, Stryker Trahan. Powerful left-handed bat, can catch and throw, probably needs to clean that up a little bit. Could end up being a potential outfield guy at the next level, depending on how the catching plays out. But really, really strong. Leaned out a little bit since we saw him up at Wrigley over the summer last summer, but you know, I think he should factor in the middle of the first round.
I agree with that. He was impressive at the Under Armour All-America game for sure, and I've heard nothing but good things about how he's performed all spring. Anybody else?
Yeah, I've got Clint Coulter, kid from Northwest up in Washington. Big body, 6'3", 215 pounds, big man strength, good power potential, quick feet behind the plate. Depending upon where he's projected at the next level, we could have him, you know, slated as a catcher and possibly move to first base depending upon if he's maxed out behind the plate. And you look at catchers today, Major League Baseball, a lot of them are agile. They're good catch and throw guys. You know, not too many guys in a major league lineup hit third or fourth, and he's probably going to hit the 3, 4, 5 slot at the next level. So he's definitely a guy going to Arizona State, depending upon what happens in the draft this year. But definitely a guy. We had him at our Team 1 Futures game back in 2010. He competed at the Wrigley game this past August. But definitely a big physical, great makeup, great kid who's definitely going to help, you know, any college baseball team and definitely a major league organization.
Those guys we had at Wrigley were both Trahan and Coulter, had a lot of raw power. I don't know if they were as advanced behind the plate, but a guy that we have seen that's a little bit more advanced defensively, can really catch and throw, is Bryan De La Rosa from Florida. A little bit smaller, that says not as much of a power bat, but probably a little bit more advanced defensively. Can really catch and throw. He's going to Florida State. Baseball player type guy with some instincts and ability to play the game. Again, not the bat that we're talking about with Trahan and Coulter, but probably a little bit more advanced defensive catcher too. So we'll see how that shakes out. Who's going to pick the glove over the bat? You know, after the bats are gone.
Yeah, I like all three of those guys. There's no doubt, and I don't think this is really a very deep catching class, at least at the high school level. So then I think the next spot that people may look for, if you want to draft a future catcher, is somebody they think might be a position change guy. And we've seen that a lot in the big leagues already, of taking that shortstop with arm strength, with pretty good hands, but maybe not the feet and range to play at the highest level there and move him behind the plate. And I could see a team that thinks Alex Bregman could do that. I know he's caught a little bit. He's hurt right now with the finger injury. But he's such a great kid and a hard worker. He led Team USA to that 16 and under gold medal, had a great year then, returned to the 18U team last year and helped lead them to the gold medal, set a New Mexico home run record in high school last year. And he's the kind of guy that will work hard enough at it that I could see him being able to stick and catch at the next level. So I think a team might take a shot on him.
Maybe like a Brandon Inge kind of, yeah. Shortstop and caught in the big leagues.
Exactly, an athletic guy that can swing it. And another one might be Wyatt Mathisen. He's kind of getting a lot of late heat down in Texas. Plays shortstop mainly and pitches for a powerhouse team down there. But he has caught a little bit in the past, and I think he fits that same profile of a good right-handed hitter, sturdy frame, arm strength, athletic. Range may be a little limited. Yeah, exactly. He's got some power too. I could see somebody taking him and maybe putting him behind the plate. And then the only other true catcher that comes to mind out there is a catch and throw guy is CJ Saylor, who we've seen before out of Southern California. He's one of those guys that pitchers like to throw to. He's not the biggest guy. He's more of a line drive bat, but he certainly can handle the pitching staff and control running game with his arm. So he might be a guy that teams would look at also.
Yeah, he's another advanced defensive catcher too.
Yeah, CJ's he's another above average catcher with above average arm. Good makeup, opera power to all fields. Great kid. He definitely has a possible future on the mound as well. Yeah, seen him up to 91. So he's another guy who's possible.
I mean, the one thing we always see, and we see with this group of catchers, I mean, it's such a position where you need a leader. I mean, these are good quality young men that we've been around, that play the game hard, that have that good body language, you know, when all the other players are looking in at them on every pitch, and guys that you can see, you know, making it through the grind of professional baseball season after season after season, and potentially making it and making an impact at the major league level down the road.